Wonderful. So today's topic is GS paper 3, right? GS paper 3 is having a very, very wide syllabus, and it is always in news as well, right? And it is scoring as well. You can score very, very good marks in GS paper 3 if it is done in a very systematic manner. Okay, so today we will see the trend of GS paper 3 in the last 2 years, how it has been doing, okay, and how should we approach this paper, how should we focus, where should we focus, and most importantly, how to cover this paper in just 30 days, right? So today is the 6th of December. If you are really serious, then I will say for 2022, by 5th of January, you should complete the syllabus of the GS paper 3, okay? So for that, you have to definitely work on the paper. You have to definitely, follow the systematic approach, and we will discuss that systematic approach. The systematic approach that I am going to discuss with you is based upon the previous year trend. I will discuss with you how this paper is behaving in the last few years, right? Excited, everyone? Wonderful. So we will do the analysis of mains 2019 and mains 2020 paper. We will see what should be the strategy and approach, right? So if we see the overall approach of GS paper 3, it is having how many components? It is having microeconomy, agriculture, science and technology, environment, internal security, and disaster management, right? So total 6 areas. By the way, this is lengthiest of the all GS papers. Which one is the shortest syllabus? Which paper is having the shortest syllabus in GS? Can you please answer? Shortest syllabus. Absolutely Satyaranjan, ethics. But GS paper 3 is having the largest syllabus. And the advantage of having this large syllabus is that you have more potential to get more marks. So large syllabus, on the one hand, it seems to be a burden. On the other hand, it is a good opportunity to get good marks, right? So if you see the overall, the weightage of the marks, macroeconomy and agriculture, out of 250 marks, at least 110 to 130. That means between 45% to approximately 55% is the weightage of these two components, economy, agriculture, right? And apart from this, we have a very big component from the internal security. In the internal security, at least 50 to 60 marks, that is 20% portion. So these are the three high potential areas. And apart from this, science and technology, environment and disaster management, all of these, they also carry approximately how many marks? 30 plus 25 plus 15. We can say around 25% to 30% weightage. Combined them together. And this is also a scoring area. Okay. So having more number of topic, on the one hand, it is challenging because you have to cover more number of you have to read more, you have to collect more sources and all. At the same time, it is better because the examiner will not be going much into depth, right? Examiner will be touching the surface of the topic. It will not be going much into the depth, so you don't have to really learn or read in a very, very deep manner. You will have to just focus on few core aspect, core areas of the topic, right? So you have to touch the topic in a 360 degree manner, but at a peripheral level, not at the very, very deep level, right? Are you getting the benefit of large syllabus? Now, if you see the paper wise breakup last two years, so this is 2019 and this is 2020. 2019, economy 50, 2020 60. This is usual range, 50 to 70. It will go maximum 70. Agriculture 60 55, internal security 40 50, Ecology 25-35, Disaster 25-15, Science and Technology 40-35. So this is the overall breakup. I have already shown you, I have already indicated that the same trend is continuing for so many years, right? So accordingly, we can devote our time. See, this is the ultimate, breakup. So we can divide, suppose we are saying 30 days. So 30 days we can divide in this particular ratio. So 60-55, that is almost 25%, almost 115 marks. Or out of 30 days, I'll say 12 days you should put for the in these two portions, and around 5 days internal security, or rather 4 days are sufficient, right? Ecology and environment, maybe 3 days. Disaster management, 1 day. Science and technology, 3 days. So 12 plus 4 plus 3 19 20 23 days. So total 23 days, and then rest of the days are for the revision and for the practice purpose, right? So 23 days for the coverage of the syllabus, and rest 7 days for the revision plus for the answer writing practice. This is how you should break up, and you should cover the GS paper 3 in the 30 days, right? Yeah, so 30 days is doable. Now, you will say, sir, is it possible to cover economic development and agriculture in 12 days? Yes, it is possible. The only thing is that you have to identify the topics in the prioritized manner first. So in the 30 days, you will be covering 70 to 80% of the syllabus, not 100% syllabus. In this 70 to 80% syllabus, you will be covering those areas which are really very very important. The topic which are very very less important, you can cover after the prelims. You can give less time, you can devote less attention, you are not supposed to do the answer writing practice. Even if you skip the answer writing practice of those questions, it is okay, it is not a problem, right? So in these 30 days you will be doing 70 to 80% of the core area, of the important area. See, you will never be able to complete the syllabus of the GS unless you work in the prioritized manner. First cover the category A topic, then cover the category B topic, and then you cover the category C topic. Category C topic are those topics which are not having much content, which are just for the sake of filling the gap, which are there in the recent current affairs, but which don't have much of the content, right? Now, some of the observations of GS paper 3. Number one, you should cover the current affairs of the last 2 years. It does not mean that you have to read each and every source. It is actually the topics that are appearing in last 2 years which you have to cover, because they will pick up the topic and they can ask from any of those topics. Number two, now see how many years ago this new syllabus was introduced. It was introduced in 2013. So from 2013 to 2020, how many years? 8 years. In 8 years, they have touched almost every topic. Now what they are trying to do is they are going to the next level. That is why they have started asking the micro areas, the micro topics, which are, for example, potential GDP in 2020, Cyberdome in 2019. They are specifically asking the name of the particular scientist, and they are asking the contribution done by that particular scientist. Hazard zone mapping. Then there are certain questions which are being repeated year after year, right? For example, inclusive growth, GST, the concept of traditional knowledge, the Myanmar border issues. So there are some repeated themes. You should actually get hold over those repeated themes. You should prepare them in a very very systematic manner with proper keywords, examples, case studies, diagrams, definitions, data, answer writing, everything you should do for these topics, right? Then they're asking the particular government schemes. They are giving the name of the government schemes. For example, Jal Shakti Abhiyan in 2020, PM Sampada Yojana in 19, National Watershed Management Program, PDS, Horticulture, Rice Wheat System in 2020. So they are actually speaking a very specific area, especially from the agriculture sector. In the agriculture sector, they are doing this thing. They are picking up the government initiative, right? So for example, in 2021, they can ask some particular initiative that has been taken in the last 1 year or so, right? Now, specifically in last couple of years, one thing is there that the questions are not that much lengthy. The questions are having one question statement, two question statement, and maximum three question statement. Normally, it is maximum 20. In some cases, it is three statement questions as well. So you should not worry about the length of the question, right? You can cover the paper if you have the content, if you can use the framework in a very systematic manner, right? Now, some of the pitfalls and the traps which people are indulging in. Number one, people think that GS3 is economy, because whenever someone asks me about the content or they ask me about any guidance, they think GS paper 3 is equal to economy. But you know, the role of economy is less than 50%. More than 50%, it is non-economy area. So you should start focusing on internal security specifically, and some areas of the science and technology. Environment, disaster management, all of that can be done very, very easily, right? So internal security, science and technology, these are two areas which you should also focus simultaneously, right? Then some students think that GS3 is equal to current affairs. Again, that is a pitfall. They think that if they cover the current affairs in a very systematic manner, then it means the syllabus of the GS paper 3 is done. Actually, current affairs are important to identify the topic which you should cover. Even they can ask some direct questions from the current affairs, but it will be exaggeration to if you say that GS3 you can cover directly from the current affairs. So never ever rely just upon the current affairs, right? Number three, from the starting phase of the preparation itself, we start reading the book on the economy, we start reading the newspaper, the magazines, the economic survey, Yojana, and we have so much content, and we think that more the content we have, more the knowledge we have, more marks we can get in the GS paper 3. And you know, people have been doing terribly bad in the GS paper 3. This year how much was the biggest score in GS paper 3? You know, it was 100. Some of our students were able to get the marks in the range of 90 to 100, and they were the best scorers, right? So GS paper 3, actually people are not focusing in a very right manner, right? So the marks are also in that manner. So this year you should focus on the GS paper 3 so that you can get good marks, right? So stop thinking that I have the content. Stop thinking that I can cover it from Ramesh Singh, I can cover from the current affairs, I can cover from the test series, I can cover from the monthly magazines or the newspaper. All of those things are supplementary resources. All of those things are, you know, fillers. They are not the fundamental sources, right? Last week only I was speaking to a student. My student got 473 rank, I think, yeah, 473 rank, Ayush Srivastav, and he was having 6th attempt. He came to me in the 6th attempt, and he got the course of GS paper 3 from me in at 6th attempt, and he really used it in a very systematic manner, and this year he got good marks in GS paper 3. He was struggling in GS paper 3 for last so many years, right? So what is the key? You should not treat that you can cover the GS paper 3 like any other paper. You have to have a very good solid background, some unique content, and that can be done if you are having the right approach. Okay, some of the most ignored areas: static part, okay, the historical part, okay. The static part, the historical part, right? That is the most ignored area. Okay, so for example, liberalization of Indian economy, this, like, we have completed 30 years very, very, very recently. Now we are talking about this topic, but actually we can interrelate this topic with so many topics. We can relate fire plans with so many topics. If we have the historical background, then we can correlate that part, historical background, with so many topics. So static part, the static syllabus, is very, very important. NCRTs, there are some very good content in the 11th Indian economic development, India-China, comparison between them, planning period strategy, 4 pillars of plan, right? And you know, a couple of years ago, there was a direct question from this NCERT in the GS paper 3 environment, carrying capacity of the ecosystem. This concept I have not seen in the commonly available sources, but it was directly mentioned in the GS in the NCERT of 11th Indian Economic Development. And I think couple of pages they have devoted to discuss and explain this concept. So direct questions can come from the NCERT if you follow the NCERT, right? So never ever ignore the NCERT. Please go through it. It will directly help you, right? The books like Kaushik Basu, Uma Kapila and Mishra and Puri, right? Now I won't suggest you to read all these books, okay? In our mains booster batch we have already covered up these sources, so I am not recommending to go and buy these books. Only some area from these books has to be picked up, which we have picked up in chapters like disinvestment, in chapters like inequality, in chapters like population control. I have, you know, added them suitably wherever it is required. So you should not go and read this book, but definitely if you read this book, you know, if you pick up the relevant content, the right content, it can help you get better marks, because your content can be unique. It can be unique from others, compared to others. You know what is happening nowadays is, you know, so many institutes are spreading their material in the online and offline market, and everyone is using the same content. Now in the exam hall, if everyone start using the same concept, same definition, same data, same everything, then do you think you will get extra marks? Never. You will never get extra marks. So not, if not in every question, but at least in maybe 5 questions or so, you can get some good content, some unique content, then you can get good marks, right? Syllabus is given in a very, very highly detailed manner. So you should prepare each and every topic. Like food processing, mein they have asked related industries, right? Scope and significance, location, upstream and downstream requirements, supply chain management, everything, right? And very important part, this syllabus is overlapping with many other subjects. Can you tell what is the overlapping? Can you tell the overlapping of GS paper 3? Can you please tell the overlapping of GS paper 3? Overlapping starting from economy, right? In economy there are concepts, for example, you know, poverty. So this is overlapping with the society portion in GS paper 3, right? Then you coming to the agriculture, somewhere it is also overlapping with GS paper 1, geography, the distribution of resources and all, right? Then coming to say internal security, it is overlapping with IR part, for example, border management, some recent initiative which is impacting the borders of India. Then we talk about environment and disaster management. It is also overlapping with the GS paper 1, geography. So for example, urban floods, this is the question they can ask in the GS paper 1 as well as they have asked in the GS paper 3, right? Pollution, air pollution, city pollution, metro pollution, they can ask in the paper 1 and they can ask in the paper 3, right? So this makes this paper very, very good, because you can score the marks in other paper. Then last is essay. Essay, they can ask direct question from essay from GS paper 3, right? So in this manner, if you prepare the content, it is going to help you in paper 1, paper 3, paper of essay, and right? And yes, some areas of historical evolution, if you see, if you are good at history, then it will help you, because economic history and all, it will help you, right? Now if we see the topics, the core topics, the first area they're asking the question is from growth development, this particular area, right? mobilization of resources, right? Last year they asked the question for potential GDP. The second area they're asking the question is from inclusive growth, right? Liberalization, like industrial policy and all, and infrastructure and investment. Like these are the five key areas, five key themes: economy, inclusive growth, liberalization, infrastructure, investment. They are particularly asking the question from these two themes. You will find repeated questions, and these two themes are not there in prelims. Like they are there, but not given much importance in the examination. In economy, if you see in the prelims examination, banking, public finance, right, taxation, national income, these 4-5 chapters are more important in prelims portion. But in mains examination, infrastructure and growth and development, these are very, very important area, right? If you see the question in 2019, question on GST, very much expected, very simple question. Enumerate means list down, right? Then GDP and inflation debate. This debate is a very long drawn debate, right? And this is in the context of current affairs. This question is also in the context of current affairs. Inclusive growth, this question is directly from the syllabus, but yes, definitely you can supplement the data, the trends, etc. from the current affairs. Then public expenditure management, this is again from the syllabus, not directly from the current affairs. So you can see there is a mixture of both kind of topic, right? 2020, this is the question from inclusive growth and sustainable development, the syllabus, static syllabus. Now if you see, this theme is being repeated year after year, 17, 18, 19, right? And then 2020 as well. Potential GDP, this question is again the basic question about growth and development. Again, this question on GDP, they are being repeated, and the focus is upon what is stopping India from realizing its full potential. The question is about, you know, what are the growth inhibitors, what are the obstacles. So sometimes you might not be aware about potential GDP, because potential GDP is a very, very small, you know, very, very, you know, micro concept. So in some cases, in some, you know, for some of you, it will be difficult to, you know, what is the meaning of potential GDP. But in that case, what you can do, you can actually read the question, and question, the first part you can ignore, second question you can write, what are the factors that have been inhibiting India from realizing its full potential GDP. So this question is about what are the growth obstacles, like for example infrastructure, lack of skill development, inequality, social inhibitors which are impacting the women from participation fully. Are you getting? So all these small, you know, reading question carefully can help you, even if you don't know the concept of potential GDP, but you can understand that actually this is talking about the growth of India, right? So never get stopped, you know, keep your mind open, keep your common sense open, and still you can answer the question which otherwise seems to be difficult, right? Are you getting it, everyone? Next, what are the main constraints in transport and marketing? This is a very, you know, again, although there have been news about this, but actually this is the syllabus, static syllabus question. Food processing, static syllabus question. That is why I am saying, don't depend upon current affairs, don't depend upon any shortcut. If you just follow the syllabus, it will be done, right? Investment, meaning of investment in an economy, this is the question from prelims, Very simple question. Discuss the factors to be considered while designing a concession agreement between public entity and private entity. Now, factors to be considered. You know, this question looks to be difficult. But if you are aware about the concept of PPP, right? If you know the concept of public-private partnership, if you know the challenges of the public-private partnership, then you can give the answer. What are the challenges of PPP? The legal obligations are not properly defined. If there is a break or if there is a obstacle on the path of any project, then there is a dispute. The dispute redressal mechanism is not properly defined. So in the agreement, what should we mention? We should mention what are the exact legal obligation, commercial obligation, right? How the dispute will be resolved, right? And what if any obligation is not met? What penalty will be levied upon the person or the entity, right? Are you getting? So this kind of answer you can develop if you have an idea about public-private partnership. So they will not ask the question directly from the public-private partnership, but they will ask the question from this area. They will ask what factors should be considered in the agreement. So factors should be designed in a manner which can take the PPP project ahead, take forward, which can remove all the obstacles in the development of PPP. So use common sense, because otherwise you will never be able to get the content from this kind of topic, right? Are you getting? This is what you can learn only if you are having the good content. Once you are confident about PPP, then you can give the answer of this type of question. This is what we mean by interlinking. You have to interlink with the available knowledge, right? Next is explain the rationale behind GST. So last year, 2019, the question is about enumerate the various taxes which have been listed. But this year, the question is about explain the rationale, the logic. So last year, they were asking the level one question. What? Are you aware about the keywords which I explained in the mains masterclass? Level one words, level two words, level three words, level four words. So in every question, in every topic, mostly what is the approach of the examiner? In first, whenever they ask the question for the first time, they will ask level one question. They will ask what? So in 2019, about GST, they asked what? What are the taxes which are part of the GST? In 2020, they're asking why? The level two question, the logic, right? Next year, they can ask some question which can focus upon level 3. That is a argument for, argument against. Maybe they can ask the question upon GST on petroleum products. Argument against, argument for. Are you getting? So they will slowly, slightly increase the level of the questions. Slightly, they will increase the difficulty level of the questions. And for that, you have to focus first on the level 1, then level 2, then level 3. Right? I hope you are getting the clarity. The question is actually weak. Easy question. Only if you are applying your common sense, you can understand, right? Then COVID, definitely it was very much expected. It was highly in news how the COVID has impacted and the federal tensions kya hai, hai na? So paper 2, paper 3 interlink ho gaya yahan pe. Paper 2, the question is on federalism. Paper 2 is syllabus. In the paper 2 syllabus, they have the syllabus of federalism. In paper 3, they are asking the federal tensions, the center state financial relations, the center state financial relations which we study in GS paper 2. They are asking here in GS paper 3. Actually, the boundary between GS 1, 2 and 3 is actually not there. This is only for the syllabus coverage. But actually in the paper, this boundary actually disappears. They can ask the question from GS2 in GS3, GS3 in GS2, right? Next question, what are the major factors responsible for making rice wheat system a success? Now, they have not used the word green revolution. They have used the word rice wheat system. But actually, this question the content will be exactly same as the Green Revolution. So you have to read the question in a very very particular manner, in a very very systematic manner, and that can happen only if you have the good idea about the content. I have shown you three questions. Potential GDP question, if you are not aware about the meaning of potential GDP, you can skip the first part, but the second part you can go ahead. You can write the growth inhibitors of India. In the question of this public-private partnership, you can get the content ideas from the PPP. In the last question, rice wheat system, this is about the Green Revolution, right? Agriculture. Now, agriculture very very important, especially the scheme portion, right? Scheme part is very very important. If you see the questions are coming primarily in these 3-4 categories. The first category of questions is about the cropping system, like this rice wheat system. This is part of the cropping system, cropping pattern, or transport and marketing, right? This is also sub part of this area only, transport and marketing. E-technology, right? Subsidies, poverty alleviation, and agricultural technology. This is also a very good area where they are asking about the systems like MSP, which is highly in use, PDS, buffer stock, technology mission, animal rearing, the livestock, right? Food processing, there was a question. I mean, you can see the question of GS paper 3 are directly coming from the syllabus, right? Food processing was there, then rice wheat system was there, and then we had this transport and marketing, right? 2019 paper, integrated farming system, national watershed project, food grain distribution system, that is a PDS. This is from the irrigation chapter, right? Then food processing, you can see repetition of the question, right? 2019 mein aaya tha, 2020 mein. Internal security. Now, internal security is something which is very very practical and which is having less number of topic, but the questions are coming. And the good thing is that there are some limited themes which are being repeated year after year. What are those limited themes? Cyber security and social media. If you see, social media news is every day there. Cyber security and social media and internal security, social media and the misuse of social media. Very very important area, right? Cyber dome, data security, you know, this is very very important area. These are the questions which are coming in the past years. I have taken from there, right? Nationalism and extremism, UAPA, Jamaat-e-Islami, left-wing extremism, northeast extremism, just surgical strike, border security, for example, Myanmar, CPEC, challenges, legal migration. I mean, you will find minimum two questions from these two, three themes. Cyber security and social media, nationalism and extremism, and border security. From these three themes, you will find at least two questions every year, right? So these are the themes which you should repeat. What are the sources? How do you supplement your material? Second ERC, there are few reports about the policy and other things. IDSA, yes, a few articles. Border management ka, right? Northeast security, if possible, give a map. You know, map is very very important, right? Map, it gives you some extra marks, right? And give the current examples. Internal security, okay. About the example, do you remember the mains maximizer masterclass? In the mains maximizer masterclass, I told you multiple type of example. Do you remember them? What type of example I told you about in the masterclass, which you can use for enhancing the marks? You remember them, everyone? Yes or no? Please tell me. Let's quickly revise. Different type of examples, different type of case studies, data. How do we include the data? No, I'm not talking about basically you are telling me about marks enhancer tools. I'm asking you different type of examples. I'm not talking about different type of introductions. Yes, Khushbu, it can be one historical example, one recent example, some popular example, and some very general example, common example. Case studies. Which type of case studies are possible? Local, national, international, very good, popular, and so on, very good. Then data, what to take care in data. Yahan pe hoga local, global, national, and some very popular case study, right? Data mein try to include some recent data and try to include the trend, the comparison. Like if you see the newspaper as well, today The Hindu, there is a data about anemia in children. So they have compared the data of the previous survey, NFHS. So even if you observe the reports, even if you observe the newspapers, you will find they are using this comparative trend, because only by comparison you can identify how much is the improvement, right? How much is the scope of improvement, how much improvement has already been taken place, right? Okay, wonderful. Now coming to the next thing, internal security. May you find these specific questions, right? 2020 questions, if you see, cyber, it was again repeated. And if border management, repeated, right? Left-wing extremism, repeated, right? Then transborder issues and all of this, LOC, it was again very, very much expected area. What else you need, my friends? The questions are being repeated. Let us see 2021, but in 2021 as well, even if they will not ask the direct questions, even if they ask the indirect questions, but one thing is sure, that you can answer those questions from the available content. So what is the biggest challenge is actually mugging up the available content. The problem that I see in the student is they are not revising the available content. They are running for the new content, or the content base that they have is not appropriate. If they have the good content, then they are not believing it. They are having the trust issues. They think that they should get some new content. See, if you are appearing for the exam in the examination multiple times, do not mean that you have to collect the content again and again. You have to read a new book or new content from, you know, every year. That will make your preparation very, very burdensome. So first of all, identify whether your content is very good or not. If your content is not good, please make it good, and then believe on this. You should revise it. For the revision, I always say daily revision, weekly revision. Number one, you have to follow this. Number two, you should make the mind maps. You should make the synopsis. You should make the audio and video clips. There is no shortcut to the revision. There is no shortcut to the revision. But yes, it can be made systematic. It can be made easier. It cannot be made shorter, but it can be made easier, right? So revision is very, very important. And if you revise and revise and revise, it will be very, very simple for you to clear the examination, right? Environment, climate change, sustainable development, pollution. These three themes repeated. If you see environment, it is about the sustainable development. It was the current affair topic we had covered up in the answer writing and the mains booster last year. Jal Shakti Abhiyan, this question is overlapping with the agriculture, but I will say yes, this question is about water security. We have discussed in the internal security mains booster. Suggest measures to improve water storage and irrigation system to make judicious use under depleting scenario. Again, this question is from the irrigation system. I mean, the question that you see, they are not that much difficult, right? And one thing you also see, you see the questions are not difficult and they are not lengthier. Like the first question is having one question. The second question is having one question. The third question is having one question. This is having two questions. This is having one question. Means even in the 15 marker, you will find maximum two questions. Mostly it is only single statement, one question directly. Science and technology, open-ended and analytical questions, right? Range is very important. If you cover the core areas, for example, nanotechnology, for example, computer and IT topics, space topics. After covering these topics, no need to go much. These are very much very important topic, and just you will find the questions either directly from this, or maybe there are some practical questions. They will ask the contribution of some Indian in the science and technology, right? Biotechnology, IPR and achievements. This third area is becoming very important nowadays, like achievements of Swaminathan, Bose, Einstein, space station, unmanned space station, fast BLE reactors and standard positioning system, right? These questions have already come, and these questions are basically achievements of Indians. These are the Indian products, Indian innovations. Now what they are doing is they are interrelating the topic with the application part. If you see the first question, how was the India benefited from the contributions of Sir M. Visvesvarya and Dr. M. S. Swaminathan in the fields of water engineering and agricultural science? So they are talking about the benefits which have been derived, right? They are actually applying the inputs of these two scientists, how they have benefited. They are talking about the application part. What is the India's plan to have its own space station and how it will benefit? Again, benefit kya hoga? If you see, almost in every question they are asking about the benefit, right? How is the government of India protecting traditional knowledge of medicine from patenting by pharma companies, right? How can biotechnology improve the living standard of farmers? So application part, benefits, the advantages, the expected advantages, all this is being focused in the questions. Mains 2020, again you see, what do you understand by nanotechnology and how it is helping? You see, every question, almost every question except maybe one question, they are asking about the application part, the advantages, how it is going to help, because from you they are not expecting the technical part. They are not making you the scientist. They are asking the application part, how much important this technology is. How is science interwoven deeply with our lives? What are the striking changes in the agriculture triggered off by the science-based technology? Again, the benefit of science in our life. This is very general question, but with the application of the available knowledge from the science and technology. Suppose you have done the syllabus in a very systematic manner, you know the application of space in our life, the application of computer and IT in our life, the application of nanotechnology in our life, and so on. Means you have to write the point from that knowledge only. For this, you don't have to search for new content. You don't have to go and find the new content. Only the available content is enough, if that content is good and very much diverse with you, right? Disaster management, NDMA guidelines, second ERC and SNDI framework. These are the key areas which you should not miss. And apart from this, basics. And now this time they are asking the स्पेसिफिक क्वेश्चंस इन द डिजास्टर, स्पेसिफिक राइट, बिट स्पेसिफिक, वल्नरेबिलिटी, हैजार्ड जोन मैपिंग राइट, देन हियर दे आर आस्किंग अबाउट द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी राइट, देन दे आर आस्किंग अबाउट द अप्रोच, दिस इज द बेसिक क्वेश्चन राइट, बेसिक क्वेश्चन, दिस इज अबाउट द क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम रिएक्टिव अप्रोच टू प्रोएक्टिव अप्रोच, द बेसिक डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट साइकिल विच द गवर्नमेंट इज फॉलोइंग नाउ राइट. सो दिस इज अ बेसिक एरिया, द वेरी वेरी ब्रॉड एरिया राइट, द वेरी वेरी ब्रॉड क्वेश्चन. नाउ वाट इज रिक्वायर्ड, हाउ टू डू, हाउ टू डू, डू यू रिमेंबर द स्मार्ट अप्रोच फॉर प्रिपरेशन ऑफ जीएस मीन्स? सो हियर ऑल्सो यू हैव टू अप्लाई दैट. कैन यू टेल द कॉम्पोनेंट्स ऑफ द स्मार्ट अप्रोच, हाउ डू यू प्रिपेयर फॉर द जीएस मीन्स? द सेम फंडा, द सेम मैनर वी हैव टू अप्लाई फॉर प्रिपरेशन ऑफ जीएस थ्री. Okay, let me share with you what you should do is basically pick up the syllabus. From the syllabus, make the static topic list. Because the syllabus is given in a very detailed manner, so you can identify the static topics. For example, here I shown the syllabus of food processing, agriculture, transport and marketing, biotechnology, left-wing extremism, all these are the static topics, right? Then last 2 years current affair topic list. I'm not saying the content, I'm taking the list. Identify the name of the topics which are in news, right? Combine this list. Combinedly, like in the Mains Booster program, we have prepared the topic of 1000 plus topics in GS 1, 2, 3 and 4. So there will be approximately 1000 plus topics in the GS 1, 2, 3, 4 in this manner. This is a complete list of topics which you should have to prepare. Then you see the previous year question pattern. Based upon this, out of the 1000 topic, you identify somewhere around 300 to 400 topics which are very important, and out of this topic you will find very very repeated themes, very repeated areas. For example, inclusive growth in paper 3, paper 2 federalism, judicial system, in the IR India China, right? So these are the key areas. So 300 to 400 topic maximum you will find. These I call as category A topic. So in our Mains Booster, we have covered these topics with the help of the lectures and the videos. And they are the very, very important topic. Questions will come from there. Prepare everything possible about this topic because they are bound to get repeated, right? After identifying the important topic, you have to prepare the 360 degree content for these category A topic. What is the 360 degree content? Every possible dimension, like starting from the basic meaning, the need, the advantages, the challenges, the problems, the limitations, the government initiatives, the way forward, the recommendations, examples, case studies, diagrams, possible mains questions, everything. I mean, everything means everything you should have about this topic, all the subtopic, all the possible current affairs dimensions, all the news which are appearing in newspaper also, everything you should have it at one place, right? This is 360 degree of category A topics, right? Then what is next? Revise. In the revision, daily revision, weekly revision and revision notes. In the revision notes, maybe mind maps of around 200 topics, maybe you can make the audio clips of 200 topics, right? Daily revision of 1 hour and weekly revision once in a week, right? Now what you will do, you will do the answer writing. In the answer writing, you always take care of 8 type of introduction hacks which we have discussed in the Mains Masterclass, right? How to write the body, Pestel approach and so many other approaches. Conclusion, marks enhancer tools. So you should apply these hacks, right? And based upon this, you should do the answer writing. Start with daily one question, then go for daily two questions. One question daily, then go to two question daily. Slowly, slowly you move, right? Then start practicing the sectional test, subject wise test, and then full length test, right? Now, for all of this, we have the paid initiatives. Some of you who are not part of the paid initiatives, we have the paid initiatives for each of these. We have separate course for the GS paper 3. You can attend the complete mains booster, which is covering the paper 1, 2, 3, 4 and essay. We have completely following this approach. The lectures and the videos on the very important topic, category A topic, the content on other topic, and end-to-end coverage of the syllabus. Every topic of the syllabus is covered up. Then we have the 3-level answer writing program, where again we are focusing on number 1, paper-wise answer writing, GS 1, 2, 3, 4, 2 questions daily. After 2 months, we provide a sectional test, where we focus upon sectional test, like every weekend you will have one particular area covered up. Then between prelims and mains, the full-length test. That kind of system we have, and you can follow that, right? If you need more information, you can fill up the counseling form. We will invite you and we will clarify your doubts. So if you need the counseling form, you can type in the chat box. I will share the counseling form. Many of you are already part of that program, so you are already taking the advantage. But from you, I have two requests. Those of you who are already part of this program, I have two requests. Number 1, revise. Revise and revise. Whatever you are covering, don't worry about the new topics. Don't worry about the new content. But revise. Number 2, answer writing. Daily answer writing is must. It should be a ritual for you. Even if you have improved a lot, still you should do it regularly and daily and daily. Till the time you get your name in the list of the UPSC, the final list, please don't skip. This is my request. Right, everyone?